H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So static variables can be used. So there is only one static variable called model. It can be used in static methods as well as non-static methods. So the model, for example, this is a static method. So I will use the static variable called model in this static method. So where I can use this? So I can use it out here. Okay, so right now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this static global variable called model in this static method called AVS. So I can just call control spacebar, I'll get that particular model variable out here. It says that it is a string type, belongs to the cars class. And if you see, there is a triangle with the S. That means it symbolizes, the triangle symbolizes a variable, and it is a static global variable. So the triangle symbolizes the static global variable out here. I can click out directly, and I can give the model name in the string format. Now, for example, the model name can be your, let's say, Camry from Toyota, and I can basically get a CISO statement for this, a logical CISO statement stating that the model of the car is concatenate this with the variable called model. Now, whenever I am using the global variable model in anywhere in this cars class, it turns to a light blue color out here. So whether I use it in this particular method or in the next method, that is accelerate method or brakes method, whenever I am using this global variable, it will turn to a light blue color. Now, we also know that static global variables can be used in non-static methods. So there are two non-static methods. Non-static methods are accelerate and brakes out here. So I will use the model out here. And let's say the restrict ourselves the value of the model as Camry, because we are speaking about Camry as the model right now. And I can give a CISO statement, a logical CISO statement. I can write down model, that is Camry X, and concatenate it with has good acceleration. And that is why it takes good speed in 2 seconds. And that's nothing but the logical definition or description of a good acceleration, that if your car has a good acceleration, it will take a good speed in a split of a second. So I've defined 2 seconds out here. Similarly, I can use the model, which is a static global variable, in non-static method called brakes. So I can just copy this so that we don't waste time and put it out here. Model can be Camry, and I can write down model. I'll call the variable model has, I can just change this particular string part, has good braking system, which makes it safer. Okay, now let us go to the concept of of our non-static global variables. So we have covered static variables. We have seen that it can be used in static methods and non-static methods. Now let's take the concept of your non-static global variables, the rules of your non-static global variables rather. Non-static global variables can be used in non-static methods only. So this is a stringent rule. So let us see that rule in Eclipse. There are two non-static global variables, principal, manufacturer, and price. So these non-static global variables can be used in non-static methods only. So non-static methods are acceleration and brake. So let us use that. So the first one is your principal manufacturer. So I'll copy it and use it in the accelerate method, which is a non-static method. So I'll just paste it. Let's say it should be actually pasted above to make it logical. Control X. Before the model, I'll paste it. So I'm going to paste the principal manufacturer as, let's say, and the value of the principal manufacturer should be in your string format. So the principal manufacturer is Toyota because Camry belongs to Toyota. And I can give a SysOut statement directly stating that SYSOUT SysOut control space bar. I can give that let's say I can write down, just call this particular variable out here directly, concatenate it with the string format is the principal manufacturer of Camry. Okay, similarly I can use the principal manufacturer definitely in your non-static. So this is principal manufacturer is a non-static global variable. It can be used in non-static method. So this is also a non-static method. So I can use principal manufacturer directly out here without any problem. So I can put it before the model out here. And the principal manufacturer, I'm putting it the value same out here because we are speaking about the Camry model. But yes, there's a repetition. So when it basically goes for a console result, the repetition of the result will be out there. So that's fine. So logically, if we are defining the value of the principal manufacturer in one of the, you know, non-starting methods, it is not to be declared in other. So instead of using it out here, what I can do is that I can use it in one of the non-static methods so that it doesn't repeat rather. Okay, now there is another non-static method called price. There's another non-static global variable called price. Okay, and this can be used, non-static global variables can be used in non-static methods only. So first we'll use it in non-static methods. So price, I will put it out here. I'm just trying to show you the rules out here. So that is why I'm repeating these non-static global variables in all the non-static methods. And then I'll show you what happens if I use these non-static global variables in static methods. So let us go ahead and give the price value. The price should be in integer format. So I'll give the price value, let's say the price of Camry is $30,000. Okay, and I can use a SysO statement. I can write down the price of Camry is the variable price, and since price is a non-static global variable, it can be used not only in accelerate method but in your brakes method also, which is also non-static. And I'm repeating the same value because I just want to show you how you can use non-static global variables over the non-static methods. Now there is a static method called ABS. Okay, so if I try to use the non-static global variables, that is model and price, in a static method, the compiler is going to show you a error. So let us use that. So what I will do is that this is the non-static global variable. I will use it in the static method called ABS and check out what happens. It says there is a syntax error. Similarly, before I define the syntax error or discuss about the syntax error, let me also use the price out here. Price is also a non-static global variable, so I'll copy it and put it to a static method. The same problem comes. So if you see out here, when you use a static global variable in a static method, there's no problem. When you use a non-static global variable in a static method, it is creating a problem. And what is the syntax error we'll get? Cannot make a static reference to a non-static field. So principal manufacturer is a non-static variable. How can you put it to a static method? According to the rule, static variables can be used in static methods and non-static method. Non-static global variables can be used in non-static methods only. So you are using the non-static global variables like principal, manufacturer and price to a static method, that is your ABS. And that is why it is creating a problem. And that is why the compiler is showing you a problem. And the problem is that it is saying that this is principal manufacturer, which is non-static global variable. How can you put it to a static ABS method? Similarly, with your price also, the same problem is cropping up. That the price is a non-static global variable. How can you put it to a static method called ABS? But wherever I'm using the principal manufacturer and price, which are non-static global variable, in a non-static method called acceleration or in a non-static method called breaks, the compiler does not show you a problem because non-static global variables can be used in non-static methods only, and that is what the rule is defining out here at this point of time. Similarly, if you see that static method can use static global variables, so we have used the global variables like your model inside the static method. Okay. So static methods can use static global variables only. See, if I try to use a non-static global variable like principal, manufacturer and price inside a static method, the compiler is showing a problem, as we have seen out here. Similarly, non-static methods can use both static and non-static global variables. That is what we have seen. Non-static methods like accelerate can use non-static global variables as well as static global variables. And that is what is the session is for, to discuss the rules first. Okay. Now, what I can do is I can comment this particular code because it is showing you a problem. I'm not going to show you how to get out of this particular situation. Okay. I can get out of this particular situation, and that's where I have to actually break the rule, the stringent rule. Okay. So I can call a non-static global variable inside a static method by creating an object of this class. And that will be discussed in the next session. So I will take the same example. I'll show you how do you implement non-static global variables inside static methods by creating an object of the class file. And in this particular session, I will comment these lines of code by going to Control Shift and back forward slash. And let's go forward and understand it. Now, I cannot get the results of the ABS method or the accelerate method or the breaks method if I do not call it in the main body or the body of the main method. Now, if you see out here, main method is always static, and that is how they have created it. That is what the Java guys have created it. And they have created the concept of main method to be static for a specific reason. If I can create a main method as non-static, then the concept of object-oriented programming cannot be enforced. That is the reason that the Java guys have created the main method as static. Now, as we have discussed earlier also, the rule is that a static, if it is a static method, it can only call static methods. It cannot call non-static methods. So until and unless I call ABS or accelerate or brakes inside the main method body, I will not get the results of it. Okay. So the rule is also at this point of time in this particular session, the rule is that static method can call only static methods. So I'll write down a static method can call only static methods inside it. Sorry, spelling mistake. So that means main method is static. So what methods I can call? The only method which is static out here is ABS. Accelerate and brakes are non-static methods. That precisely means that I cannot call accelerate and brakes inside the main method which is static according to this rule. So if I do control spacebar, I will see the method called ABS. And this is the symbol for your functions, the green symbol. And it's a static function, that is why the S is coming. It has a void return type, belongs to the car class. So if I do control spacebar, I am able to only see the ABS option. That is your static method called ABS. Do I see the option of accelerate and brakes, which is a non-static function or a method? I don't see it. If I scroll down also, I will not see it. Okay, so I can use the ABS method out here because ABS by whole is a static method. So I can call a static method inside the main method, which is static. I'll get the result of the body of the ABS. So when the compiler moves from top to down, it encounters this particular function. It'll go to the body part and execute the body part of ABS. Now, enter. I'll do again control and spacebar to get to actually use the non-static methods like your accelerate and brakes. I don't see those options out here. I will not see the option. So I will forcefully use this by copying it. And let's see what happens. I will get a syntax error. Why? Because it will say that you cannot make a static reference to the non-static method called accelerate. Accelerate is a non-static method. How can you refer it to a static main method? Main method is static. That is why this is coming. Similarly, I will forcefully use the brakes method, which is non-static method. Copy it and put it out here. Put a terminator sign. The same aspect will come, stating that cannot make a static reference to a non-static method. So brakes is a non-static method. How can you call it to a particular main method which is static? So I need to comment these. And then if I run it, there will be no problem. I'll get the result, which is nothing but the body part of your ABS. So ABS has one println command that cars have ABS to make it safer. That is what it is coming. It has another println command called as model, whose value is Camry. And this is the println command for model. The model of the car is concatenating with model. So it is that's giving you that result. The model of the car is Camry. Now, if you look at this particular aspect, according to these rules, the stringent rules, I cannot call a non-static method inside a static main method first. I cannot use a non-static global variable inside a static method. So these rules are stringent, and this creates restrictions for coding. And that is why, to break these rules, the concept of objects came into force. And we'll see the concept of objects in the next session, where I'll break the rules for the same class file called cars. So thanks very much for attending it. And if you have any questions, please revert.